Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a classic letterpress poster. Letterpress printing is known for its subtleties of texture and color. I created this one based on a poster produced by Hatcho Print Company. This tutorial is in two parts. In part one, we'll create our background and transform a photo into three overlapping images. In part two, we'll add text, a few graphics, and a stained texture to age our poster. I provided a Photoshop file so you can follow along that's located in my video's description or project files. It includes this stained paper texture, a letterpress ink texture, and a plain white background. Double-click the bottom layer to open its layer style window. Click Inner Glow. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, the technique is precise, and the source is center. The choke is 100%, and the size is 70 pixels. Click the color box, and pick a color you'd like for your background. Since I already know the color I want, I'll just type it in the hexadecimal field, FFDB00. Once you pick your color, press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Make the texture layer visible and active. Change its blend mode to Screen. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. We want the adjustment layer to affect just the one layer beneath it. To do this, either click the clipping mask icon or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Make the input midtones 0.50 and the input highlights 154. Open a photo of someone or something that you'd like to use for this poster. It can be color or black and white. The first step will be to convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as allow the filters that we'll be adding to it to be fully editable. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. We need to separate the subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. There are many ways to make the selection, and your choice should depend on the characteristics of your photo. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, make its radius between 5 to 10 pixels, depending on its resolution. Drag the tool over your subject to select it. If you need to remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. After your subject is fully selected, click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. To place it onto your poster, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of your poster. Without releasing your mouse or a pen, drag it down onto your image and release. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. When you see this message, it's just telling us that the smart filters will be temporarily turned off while we use the Transform tool. Just click OK. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag the corner in or out. Leave room for any text that you want to add later. Then press Enter or Return. Change its blend mode to Multiply. Your foreground and background colors need to be black and white respectively. If they're not, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. open the sketch folder and click halftone pattern. Make the pattern type dot, the size 2, and the contrast 3. Then click OK. If you want to brighten your subject, click the adjustment layer icon and click levels. As you did earlier, clip it to the layer beneath it. I'll make the input highlights 218, but feel free to brighten it to your liking. Shift-click on your subject to make it active as well, and press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy of both layers. Press and hold Shift as you drag the layer to the left. Make your top subject active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Solid Color. Pick a color you like for your overlapping subject and click OK. Change its blend mode to Screen. Click the top layer and Shift-click on your subject copy to make all three layers active. Make a copy of them by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold Shift as you drag the second copy to the right. Next, we'll reveal your middle subject through one of your other subjects on either side, and then offset the subject, which is common in mass-produced letterpress printing. Scroll to the bottom subject and Ctrl-click or Command-click on its layer mask to make a selection of its shape. Scroll to the top subject, which is your subject on the right, and make its layer mask active. Press Alt or Option plus Delete to fill the selection with black. Doing this masks out this area of your right subject, which in turn reveals your middle subject. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To offset the right subject, press the right arrow on your keyboard once, and then the up arrow once. To consolidate space in our Layers panel, let's place all of our subject layers into its own folder. To do this, scroll to the top and make the top adjustment layer active. Scroll to your bottom subject and Shift-click on it to make all the layers that comprise your subject active. Press Ctrl or Command G to place them into a folder. Name your folder and change its blend mode to Multiply. Go to the texture layer and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it above the folder. Clip it to the folder by pressing Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. There'll be areas of your subject in which the texture is appearing white, so to remove those areas, press Z to open your Zoom tool and drag over your middle subject to zoom into that section. Open your Move tool and drag the texture to move it until you don't see any more white on your subjects. To make the texture more subtle, open the Levels window by pressing Ctrl or Command L. Drag the output white level to approximately 100 and click OK. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. In Part 2, we'll add text, some graphics, and age it with stains and creases. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.